Welcome to WHU Inside Business. My name is Christian Schlereth and I'm sitting here together with Alexandra Kirilov, senior scientist and co-lead of the preference modeling hut of GfK. Alexandra, thank you for coming.
Yeah, thank you for having me here. It's a really great pleasure for me.
With your award-winning project, you showcase the value of virtual reality for the purpose of conducting market research studies. Could you briefly introduce us in the respective business context and what you've done there?
Yeah, sure. Let's think, for example, at the innovation testing or product optimization area. So you see the main issues we are facing nowadays with our traditional way of marketing research, we are lacking realism. So in the best way, in the best case, we are showing only pictures or 2D models. We are also testing the products in isolation, right? So we are missing the context. If we want to try or to test a car, what we are doing currently, we are placing the car with a white background or in a gray room, right? Why not placing it in a real showroom to see how the context can influence the decision? And what a better way to overcome these problems than virtual reality? And this is actually what we did. We placed the respondents in a real showroom, virtually simulated, place in the showroom five different cars, let the respondents to actually walk, teleport, look around the cars, very closely inspected from the aesthetics, but also from the additional configuration like engine type and so on. And at the end, we challenge them to make a selection, to select which car they like most. And we repeat this experiment several times until we manage to understand their true preferences.
As you've mentioned, your project enabled participants to teleport, to pick up objects, to press buttons. How much did you actually learn from the gaming industry to implement such capabilities in VR?
Well, a lot, I would say. So first of all, we had to restrain ourselves in the amount of text we can display for the participants, right? So we are coming from the traditional research. We are used about using mounds of text, explaining very detailed task, explaining how to teleport, how to pick objects, everything. Yeah. But in virtual reality, we do not have this space to display text because it's very difficult to read. So what we needed to do, it was to create a very intuitive application. Let's take, for example, the walking option. Seems a very easy task in day by day, but in virtual reality might not be so intuitive. How we did this? At the beginning, we had a training phase. We placed the participants in a simple, empty virtual reality simulated room. The only object in that room was a desk. The starting point was 1.5 meters in front of the desk. Respondents placed in an empty room, what they needed to do, I mean, the only thing, it was, okay, let's reach the table. So they automatically start walking. Yes. This was such an easy task for them. Mm-hmm. They learn it intuitively. Other example, on the table were some paper sheet. In order to read what was on the paper, they needed to pick up, to grab the paper and to bring it close to their eyes. So again, naturally, intuitively, they use their hand with the controller in it to pick up the desk. And this was the way we learned them about picking up objects, without text, without any kind of verbal explanations.
How did the VR technology influence the behavior of the participants compared to, for example, sitting in front of a computer?
So compared to more traditional way of data collection, we saw that virtual reality actually allows the respondents to express their preference beyond conventions and beyond the rational sounds. For example, on a tablet, they selected a diesel SUV. This was their preferred car. Okay, a car which satisfied a lot of their day-by-day needs. Yeah. On the other hand, same participants in virtual reality selected an electric coupe. So I really can say that virtual reality enables respondents to or enables emotions to influence their behavior.
And probably the study was done way before the Dieselgate, right?
It was done with some months before the whole explosion of the Dieselgate.
Which limitations of the VR technology did you come across during your studies, such as, for example, motion sickness for the participants?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I know that this is a very debatable topic, let's say like this. But for our piece of research, I personally conducted and trained all these participants, over 200 participants. And I can say, first of all, that virtual reality is feasible for nearly everyone. Mm-hmm. So everybody managed to use the technology. Mm-hmm. And we had no motion sickness event. Nobody felt dizzy and nobody had to break off the experiment. Mm-hmm. And this insight was reconfirmed by two other virtual reality studies we conducted. Mm-hmm. So in total, we can talk about more than 1,000 respondents, and we had no motion sickness event. So I think that this is not a topic nowadays with the current technology and with the current computer power.
Which other business opportunities do you see for VR technologies in the rather near future?
I mentioned early about product optimization, innovation testing area, right? But why not talking about car clinic? In fact, I think that here virtual reality will play a major role. Also, copy testing, advertising testing, and even qualitative research.
Mm-hmm. Alexandra, thank you very much for sharing your insights.
Thank you so much for giving me the opportunities. It was a pleasure being here.